On January 24th in Cairo, a 32-year-old political activist and mother, Shaima El-Sebar, came to celebrate the anniversary of the revolution. And within minutes, without any apparent provocations, the police arrived, tried to disperse the crowd, and she was shot in the back and died from her wounds on the way to the hospital. Shaima was hit in the back, in the neck, on the side of her face by what looks like to be a burn shot. And in fact, the medical authorities confirmed that she was fatally shot with burn shot that killed her by lacerating her lungs and heart. We collected a lot of evidence of what happened on that day. We talked to several eyewitnesses, we found pictures, and we found this video evidence which we believe show the death of Shaima. You'll hear right at the beginning of the footage two shots, which we believe were the first two shots to disperse the crowd, and then a few seconds after that, what we believe to be the fatal shot. Let's look at it. The first two shots, you can see police officers in black uniforms walking towards the demonstrators behind the banner. This, we believe, is the fatal shot that killed Shaima. Our analysts spent a lot of time looking at this video evidence frame by frame. We stabilized it, we zoomed in, we cross-referenced also still pictures that were taken at the scene within seconds of the shooting. And you can clearly see here this police officer getting in a shooting stance, pointing his gun towards the protesters, and then the shot rings, and you can see the protesters here running away from the police, and Shaima with her gray sweater falling to the pavement. We believe that the evidence strongly indicates that this man in the center with the black face mask is the one that shot Shaima. Over the last few years, hundreds of people have been killed by police in demonstrations in Egypt, and frankly, you almost never get this type of evidence to document it. You often have to rely more on eyewitness. But despite this wealth of evidence, pictures, videos, the police is completely denying that anything happened on that day, claiming that this evidence was somehow fabricated. We believe these denials are simply not credible, and the government should seriously investigate and hold the people responsible for this death accountable.